Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I will going to discuss about this circuit. I already make a video for you. I told everything in this video, but I miss one thing. In this video I told you that is a push-pull amplifier. Today I have to discuss, it is not only push-pull amplifier, it also boost power. So you can tell this circuit boost amplifier. Now why I tell this circuit boost and power boost amplifier, I just describe this. Imagine here is a signal generator. You can get your signal from this IC and want to drive this pair of MOSFET and also this transformer. First of all, when you put 24 volt in this part for better output, powerful output or actual output to drive next part of the circuit, then you have to push the gate of this MOSFET, so you have need power, but you cannot get power directly from this IC. It is also drive with 12 volt, but it is not powerful. So much you have to need so much power to drive this pair. Then if you apply this circuit, that means power amplifier, power boost amplifier, push-pull amplifier, whatever it is, but you get a more power for this circuit. You cannot directly drive through this pass to this bridge. So you use this circuit for your next circuit, I mean a edge bridge circuit, that is the edge bridge, you know. And also here is a transformer, you have to drive also and get this type of pulse output from this transformer. But that is not my goal today. I want to drive high power edge bridge circuit with this driver. You know that is your driver circuit. I want to drive this circuit. For that I use here 24 volt. See that. Then I get here this type of pulse. Actually, when I drive the MOSFET through this pass, there is a two different thing. One is directly on the MOSFET, another is confirmed that MOSFET should be off or MOSFET perfectly off. This part do this. Why I draw this line from the output pulse, just not from zero level, some higher level, because that is your threshold voltage. You know pulse will come back below to threshold voltage, that means MOSFET is off. I already told you. But this part also confirm that MOSFET fully off, confirm, that is a safety circuit. Now you have to see the output circuit, it is important. I want to show you. First of all, I have no need to this curve. After that I tell everything. Just now I remove this curve. When you drive this edge bridge through this driver, then you have to need full loop output of this transformer. In that page I show you two loop, but I make a full loop here output of this transformer, but that is a T1B and that is T1A. That means transformer are same but in for loop. Now look this buckles, that is important. Zero level, top level, zero level, ground level, minus level, then again zero and negative. So that is your loop A, because transistor is A, that is your pulse A. Pulse A and pulse C in same phase. See this. Pulse A and pulse C are same phase. And I just make a difference in that point. Look at this. Here is no horizontal line, but here is a. When your DC supply coming A and D, but it never come to the transformer until unless this pair, that means A and C or D or B, goes to on. If both pair is off, that means your power never come to the transformer by any way, not for that way and also not for. Now when you put this pulse into this MOSFET, and for better understand what is the purpose of this, I already tell everything, so I cannot discuss anything about this circuit. But when this MOSFET is on, your 310 volt come to this way, that is the way come to transformer, one end of the transformer, then goes to MOSFET C, then goes to ground. But when this pulse is goes to zero, then minus, then this pair, obviously this pair A and C goes to off, and pulse B and pulse D goes to on. So in that time 310 volt first arrive on D, then goes to transformer, then goes to B, then goes to ground. A little interesting matter is this coil always change over. Sometime that is your input, sometime that is your input. That means this coil is sometime as a clockwise, sometime it is anti-clockwise. So you get full pulse, full, I mean from positive to negative, full. That means 310 volt, you can get 310 volt like as this type of pulse here. That is sinusoidal curve. That is a sinusoidal curve you get here. But there is a problem. When you change this value of this resistance or this value of this capacitor, if you change the capacitor value, if you use here your trimmer, then you can change it. If you use your potentiometer, then you can change it. Then when it is properly tuned with this circuit. Look at this, here is a capacitor, so here is a coil, so it is a tank circuit. All we know that it is a tank circuit. All we know that. Then when you tune the circuit with a proper frequency, you get a sinusoidal curve output of this transformer. That is your output curve. But there is a problem. There is a problem. You get also this type of parasitic curve with your sinusoidal curve. Look at this. You get this each and every time and make a problem. That is a parasitic curve. See this. If you don't use this circuit in here, resistance and capacitor in series with the parallel of MOSFET, each and every pair, both pair, B and C, B and D is a pair, A and C is a pair, but you have to use this circuit in for every MOSFET. When you put this circuit, then you get a different type of output here. Look at this. Fully sinusoidal curve, there is no disturbance, noise is no noise. Your MOSFET working as cool and your circuit also working cool, and you can get more power because we know when we put the pulse and convert it to sinusoidal curve, then we get more power and it is efficient, more efficient circuit you can get. But I have to tell one thing that is very interesting. When this curve, which is appear for parasitic curve, that is a parasitic curve, we know when is it is goes to left, that means this head goes to right. This head, minutely watch that, this head goes to right. When this head, top head goes to left, then button edge goes to right. And you get a problem. Which type of problem you can get, I will explain. When your curve goes to left, then A and D goes to heated up. When that is goes to right, then you get a problem from this pair C and B. Very interesting. I faced this. I lost so many MOSFET IGBT for that curve, but I cannot find this. Nobody can tell me why it is, how to solve it. I find out it. After that, I use the circuit and solve the problem and make this type of pulse for high voltage transformer. That means, I mean, high voltage is 40 kilovolt. I drive this through the circuit and it is working properly. I am very satisfied. So I think I have to share something with you. That's why I share you. If you face same problem, you do this, you can get result. And you know what to do. Please do this. Thank you. Thank you for watching.